many times, many ways. Merry Christmas to you. Phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to
Okay, so here I am. I forgot to change my game over. Damn it. Hey, you got my Dark Mark working? Did you try to get the No, I was never working on Napoleon. I was trying to get the Empire to work. I wanted the Empire. Total War. How are you doing, sir? Yeah, I've been... I don't know which one do I use to stream, because I got Darth Mod Empire and then the Empire up. So which one do I use as my game source? Yeah, I know there's one for Napoleon. I wanted one for Empire. I was feeling very Empire-y. Okay. Oh, okay. So, there it is, I got it. Here, the server uploader. What are you doing down there, dog? Sounds crazy. Yeah, no, I just feel very drawn towards Total or Empire lately. It is still one of my favorites. And we'll see what Darth Mod is like on that. Eventually, I'd like to try Napoleon with Darth Mod as well. Tried a few other mods for Empire. Exactly. No, it you know, has the American campaign, basically. And since this time of year always puts me into mind of the American Revolution and all that, that's probably where it's coming from. Wait. How can you hear me right now? It says my mic is... Wait, can you hear me now? Were you able to hear me earlier? I bet you were hearing me through some other mic. Yeah, I wish they would just like combine them, use the world map. Okay. Yeah, use the world map and just you know, be the awesomeness that it could be. Demon, pretty good. How's it going with you, Ash? Thanks for popping in. Let me get some shout outs for both of y'all. Pretty good. We just started. I'm starting trying a new mod on this game. Empire Total War. I'll start with Val since he was here first. Yeah, so it's going to be interesting. Increased troop numbers, is better explosions and stuff like that. Just chilling, spend my day catching Pokemons. Now I'm going to torture myself with some DVD. That's the dream, isn't it? That's the dream. Spend the day catching Pokemons and some DVD. Yeah. That's the dream right there. I wanted to play some DVD soon because I got my wonderful little... overlay that I made, and I've barely used it. Yeah, that. And I've barely used it. You know it makes me chuckle so much. For DVD. I don't know. Gaming. Oh, is there really? Killer too, I bet. Yeah. I've been wanting to try out this game though. So I'm gonna grind on it for a bit. I'm going to make America great for the first time in this game. Orders coming. Hold on. Let's see. It's two times for everyone, and plus you still have the bonus on whatever side it's on. Oh, wow. Oh, that's really good. All right, Val, thanks for the lurk, and thanks for popping in. We always like when you come in. What is going on in my screens? So, yeah, we're going to get to starting... I already did the opening moves out when you have to sell all your tech because I'm not sure if the Darth mod fixes that. Where just right after the first turn, all the other nations get all the techs and you still have to research them all. So you sell all your techs to them because they're going to have it anyway, but you get all this money to start with. That's the trade-off. Yeah, that's crazy though. You keep... really should be playing some DBD, but it's all right. I still haven't spent all my two million points from the last thing they did. So anyway, we're gonna start off with doing all the single $100 improvements to the lands, like I always do. Ones that are still in the hundreds of dollars. Till 26. Oh, cool. Cool. Then I don't miss out. So we have a school, a farm. Let's do something to make people happy. I think this gives happiness, right? Yep. Get a coaching in. Do all the small stuff first. So are you going to play some killer? Or are you going to stream? What's up? Trying to get all my characters. Oh, okay. Yeah. 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 You're getting all your characters at P9. Yeah. My family was canceled because my nephew is sick, so I can play to my heart's content. Well, that's sad, but at least you get some more play time. Whatever side has the bonus, right? Okay. Yeah, it's sad your nephew's sick, but at least you get some extra playtime. We don't do Christmas till... Well, my side of the family does Christmas on Christmas Eve, and then my wife's side does it on Christmas Day, so I have things on both those days, but I'll be doing some streaming Sunday morning for sure, before anything gets really kicked off. He'll be fine. We decided that we didn't need to share. Right. We will be postponing until the 6th to give the virus time to go away. Oh, okay. Sometimes you gotta do that kind of thing. Let's see. So, the first moves I'm supposed to combine these armies.
Forward! Ready for crown and country!
And I'm gonna take the Cherokee lands over. Because they're the bad Cherokees, not the good Cherokees. Because I wouldn't take land from good people, be a colonizer. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. It's a different time, folks. Okay. Oh, yeah, we don't need this Christmas music anymore. Actually, it wasn't too bad. I'll just keep it down. Drop it down a little bit. Not the Christmas music. Is it distracting or overpowering? I'm not a big fan of it, but it was the only Twitch safe Christmas music I saw on Spotify. What am I thinking? No, I read about this. There's actually any old Christmas stuff is actually good, right? It's fine, okay. Any old Christmas stuff is fine, apparently. What am I thinking? We just need old Christmas stuff. Just can't have it in your own. Oh, okay. Yeah, I didn't know that. When I first started streaming, they had something like that, Soundboard, I think it was called, and I used that a lot, and then they took that away. There you go. Yeah, this music is fine. Right. Okay. But did they remove it from your VOD? I wouldn't mind it. But yeah. I looked this up the other day because my wife was playing Christmas music in the background, and they said that it's okay, and I don't think it got muted, so pretty easy to do. So you just have to split out your audio, which I do. I have everything split. If I can play it in a browser, it'll be on a different, but. I mean, if they mute it anyway, I can play this music too. That separate track on your VOD versus stream audio. I'm not sure what you mean by VOD versus stream audio. No, I don't. Oh. That's what that means. I just thought, you know, like I have a music coming from my browser that's on its own. Audio, and then my mic and my game is all separate. But you mean, like, do I have an audio that's being recorded and one that's being streamed? That I don't know. I'm on the right track. Okay. I'm on the right track. So which one would be my VOD? Set the numbers in OBS. Okay. The numbers. You mean the numbers? Like I have an output input capture. I got I have a music, which is Spotify. Sound alerts, mic aux, game aux. Discord. Oh. Well, I'll look into it. But what you need is the advanced settings. Okay. Yeah, I have advanced settings. Vans Properties? Yeah, I mess with that sometimes. Try not to, because I'll end up... Google Twitch VOD track. Yeah, I will. Well, that makes sense, because sometimes I get, you know, I'll get muted. Even if I play like a Twitch safe album on Spotify, sometimes one song will get muted. I know it only matters on your VOD, right? Because they're not watching my stream. There's still so much I want to actually figure out. So much I have to figure out. Oh, and by the way, stream, we do not have a camera because I didn't plug my camera in before my cat came and sat on top of my computer where it plugs in at. So, he's the boss. We have no camera. So he moves. We'll get to it. I mean, it's still a bit of a risk to play copyright music, right? Makes sense. Sir. All right. So, can I recruit anything that can be come into this fight? Probably. So this is the first time I'm ever using some of these units of them. This is a brand new mod. See, we have militia now. Minutemen. The Minutemen have a better accuracy. They have a worse defense. I'll be lurking while I dip my toes into DBD waters. Okay. Yeah. Good luck and get them blood points. Get enough for both of us. Get so many that you get all your characters to 10p. Yeah, I already shouted you out. You have a good time. Pop in here when you like. Tell us how it's going. Keldon's Light Dragoons. I don't know those at all. Never seen those. That's a new unit. It's a little weak. Hopefully it's less expensive. Nope, it's way more expensive. No, it is. It's 800. Okay, so it's a little less expensive. 3520. I'm surprised it took him all the way to like Warhammer 3 before they ever realized that we need a comparison of troops, so we don't have to keep on doing this. We're trying to compare two troops. Two types, anyway. 9, 6, 13, 8. 7, 10. 9, 6, 13, 8. So defense is better. 9, 6. Charge bonus is weak. Morale is better. 125, 50, 15, 20. 125, 50, 15, 20. So better ammunition. Probably because they're supplying themselves. 20, then the skills are worse, accuracy is worse, and range is worse. No, wait. Reloading skills better. Accuracy is not too bad. Huh, pretty interesting. Yeah, they did that too. They put the carbine's range the same as the line infantry. Oh, even better than the line infantry. That's going to be weird. So, Minutemen, 110, 35, 15, 110. So, again, ammunition's better on the Minutemen than this militia infantry. Reloading skill is better. Nope, worse. And accuracy is a little better. 4, 4, 13, 4, 10, 5, 6, 6. And, yeah, melee... Charge bonus, defense, and morale is a lot better on Minutemen. So I guess that makes sense because the militia would be more organized. But militia are Minutemen. Well, the Minutemen were specific types of militia that were organized all over New England. They followed a little different rules. They were probably basically a private militia, where militia, which those existed as well. They were all Minutemen in the Revolutionary War, were state organized groups. They were both funded with state money whenever possible, but the militia were actually organized by the state, while the Minutemen were basically freemen's militia. They were funded when state was possible, but they were organized to be able to move like they were. But it was very interesting. Last book I read about the American Revolution really opened my eyes a lot about so many things. It's actually about Paul Revere, but Paul Revere was so involved with these groups that they covered all that. Even Paul Revere, I thought I knew all about Paul Revere a long time ago, but yep. Ooh, nice. Skirmishers. So, and if you guys are just joining, if anybody's joining, I am just looking at the different troops I got, because I'm doing Darth Mod for the first time. Let's look at the light infantry. Real mixed bag as far as what was better. Oh yeah, well, the long riflemen knock out Marion's Rangers by far. Yeah, even like morale morale, the only way that they're better. Oh, and charge bonus. I'm using different troops. So these guys are good. First Pennsylvania Rifles. That's another group of their range should be far greater. I don't like that at all. I don't like that their range is the same as linemen. Pennsylvania. That's a bad one. That's bad. Pennsylvania Rifles, people. How are they going to have the same range as linemen firing muskets? That's crazy. Crazy, crazy. They were literally sharpshooters. George Washington had so much to say about the Pennsylvania Rifles. And, you know, he always kept them to guard the rear. You know, they'd face off against the Jaguars of the Hessians, and you know, the hunters, you know. That's sad that they brought him down to 110 range. That is really sad. They fought a different kind of war than linemen. They were light infantry. So that you would knock them down to 110 range. Which Morgan, if this is the Morgan I'm thinking about, veterans of the Corps had a major role in the Continental Army during the American Revolution War, including Major General Israel Puttons and Brigadier General John Stark and Moses Hansen. The traditional uses of military term ranger had limited applications during the later war. Various state governments employed ranger units for local frontier security, but the Continental Army formed very few, partly because George Washington considered frontier security a local responsibility and focused national military forces toward opposing regular British and German army units in formal battle. Washington was sort of stand-up battles, but he became a big supporter of irregular units. Morgan would become one of his lifelong friends. At first, he wanted a traditional European battle, but he came to understand the use of irregular units and asymmetrical
attrition war, you know, wars of attrition strategies. So it's kind of weird because this is after the revolution. So anyway, it's okay. We will deal with it. That's crazy, though. Look at these guys. 170 range. Oh, what's the range of a Okay, so they fixed the range. They made the ranges wider, but I do believe for the artillery. But I do believe that they also made them less accurate. So. Did they fix grenadiers? No, grenadiers can't form square? Oh, well, I don't think they list it here. Okay, so they might still be able to form squares. That was one of the dumbest things, that the grenadiers weren't able to form squares in the Empire Total War. Grenadiers were taught to form square. They were deployed, you know, by ranks, but they knew how to form square. They were trained, they were part of a battalion. So, anyway. Or, I mean, a regiment, sorry. They had a grenadier battalion. Anyway, so I'm not sure what troops I'm going to end up using. I'll probably use a little bit of both to start with and just kind of see which ones I like. But, anyway. For these opening moves, I'm gonna need some troops, so... since I'm going to try to do this, we'll see how well it works. It should be all right, but we'll see. In the walkthrough, you're supposed to take Cherokees out by the second turn. We'll see how well that works. I'm going to go ahead and pop a militia out in the case I'm thinking we're gonna need them, so we'll pop a couple militia units out. Okay. I did more to prepare for this game. I made a list. Oh, cat moved. We can have a camera. I don't know about you, but I really like when streamers have cameras. Even if they got an ugly mug like mine. Lily, what you doing? What you doing that you ain't in my chat, girl? What you doing? Why ain't you up in my chat? Yeah, but you could give me a view at least. I'm Poe, I need views. There I am. There's my ugly mug. Okay. It is two. You're just saying that because you love me. You know what, Lulu? Would you make me coffee? Do you know how to make me coffee? Yeah, but I don't use the percolator. Unless I cleaned it. I don't remember when the last time I cleaned it. If it looks clean, go ahead and use it. I appreciate it. What am I doing to you all? I don't know why I'm doing this to you all. Alright, gonna start this game out. I always get this little, like, trepidation before I start a campaign, because I really... I don't know if this song's gonna be legal. So I'm gonna ahead flip it. That one's a little newer. Yeah, let's go back. One thing I've noticed was the... with Darth mod is that you can't I'm done down here. Here's Nathaniel Green, my man. You can't do things. What was I gonna say? Lulu, you remember what I was gonna say? No. If I click off of the screen to do things on my second monitor, it minimizes the game screen for me. I don't know if it does for you guys or not, but I guess I can check. Let me see. Huh? I'm still there. All right. So it doesn't freeze, guys. Well, then it doesn't matter. I can always enlarge it. It's okay. No big deal. No big deal. What do you mean, no big deal? I don't know. There we go. So I'm going to name. I use the naming of the bodyguard function to give ranks to my generals. So I'm, of course, Nathaniel Greene, Washington's best general. Not best, but his most reliable. We'll give him the lieutenant general. You see, that's the only place it matters. It shows up right down there. I mean, it really doesn't matter, but I do things like that because I'm weird. I wish it would just cycle through the armies. I hate that it goes through all the other crap. Yeah, Nathaniel Green's there. I'll give him lieutenant general. We will give Crazy Mad Wayne here. We'll give him we'll make him a brig for now. He might get the major general role. We could use it, but right now we don't need it. So we'll just make him brigadier general. He's gonna like it, or he's gonna leave. You know, that's his choices. Sullivan. We will also give Sullivan the brigadier for now. Sullivan. He's always led the vanguard, so. But, you know, he had a tenuous relationship with George Washington. George Washington kind of blamed him, kind of unjustly. I'm just going to say it, Georgie. You unjustly blamed him for some stuff that happened around Manhattan. It wasn't your proudest moment, but hey, we all got those. So he's stuck at Brigadier General. He's got the Exploring Officer, which is amazing. Gives you more movement range, so that's gonna be good for him because he's more than likely going to be doing a lot of this movement down here. I used to use Nathaniel Greene for that, and I might still, but I might send Nathaniel Greene out to do some island hopping or something as I take over all of North America. And Wayne always takes Arcadia, Quebec, Montreal, and then I start shipping him around the North Pole here, around Canada to finish out these territories as I knock Britain out of North America. But we'll see what happens. I mean, that's my regular move, but maybe Darth Maud makes it harder and I can't do it. I don't know. We will see. We will start. Let's see. So we need to start building some of these armies up. We'll move him to New York. And we're going to start building these two units up. Sir, I forgot what's... Yeah, he's got the military padre. It's plus... He gets a bump in stuff, too. So I'm going to need ten units in each of these to get them where I want them. So recruit. So they're all gonna get. I think. Let's see. Wayne's not gonna get one of the legacy regiments. Well, no, I think he does. Yeah. It's hard to get troops all the way down to Sullivan down here. So. I guess I can get him the first Maryland. I play this game not so much what's the best idea. I play it really just what's the most historically accurate. I don't have the first Maryland yet. So I will give Morgan the Delawares.
where I messed up. We gotta do his recruitment before even the city. We can do global recruitment. So that's his first Delaware's coming. What does he have? He's got all the light infantry. And I think he's got one ranger, so I'll send him one of these light infantry. Ah, press the right buttons or go home. Okay, so he'll have one of those. This guy will go to him. Recruit. You recruit a regular lineman. Wonder what militia are going to be like, though. Well, I'll give him a militia and a regular lineman. And then I'll use those light infantry for now. I'll probably change them up later. Does he have cavalry? He doesn't have cavalry, so he needs cavalry. We will... I'll tell you what, we'll give him a legacy unit. The Philadelphia Light Cavalry! Light Cavalry! Okay. Recruit. What else do we need? He's gonna need a couple guns, so we'll give him... I love that howitzers are available from the start. That makes good sense to me. I like that. So we will give him howitzers. He already has one. Also has one lineman, so he just needs one more. Let's give him the grenadiers. Let's see what grenadiers are like now. What kind of changes they did to grenadiers. And we're gonna give him some horse artillery. Oh, wait. Did they? Oh no. Okay, I just accidentally clicked off someone. I was about to say, did they give me a limit to this? Okay. There you go. And then we will give Wayne the Pulaskis and Lancers. We will... What else did he have? He's got plenty of... Actually, he has plenty of cavalry, so let's not give him Pulaskis. Well... Yeah, let's not give him Pulaskis. Well... Let's give him Pulaskis. We'll make him a cavalry-heavy unit. Of course, we'll give him his guns. Oh no! They did put a limit on six. So I don't want a limit. I don't want to. That's weird. Okay, so we'll give them both a 6 and a 3. How's that? They put a limit on how many horse cavalry I can have. Horse cavalry, horse artillery. Does this show the limit up there? Yeah, it shows the limit right there. So I have 3 of 2, 2 of 3. So we'll give them each 1 3 and 1 2. How's that? Can't be mad about that, can they? Probably. Okay. We won't worry about building you up too much higher. We will give you infantry. I'll probably check out Continental Marines too. I'm spending like crazy though. That's okay. Can't do much without spending some money. Oh, and you don't have any. You have one light colonial. We'll give you a long rifle. No, let's do that. Let's do the First Pennsylvania. Let's see how that turns out. And then, wait. How come?
How come that happens? How come I have plenty of money? Are there only a certain amount of tight, light ones that you can have? Oh. That's weird. Because I have plenty of money. So it's not money. Do they? I wonder why that is. Huh. Well, we'll see. If we have to disband some units, we'll disband some units. All right, and then water-wise. Water-wise, we're going to send these guys, because I don't have any other boats, right? Yep, these are my only boats. We're going to send them. It recommends sending them to, like, a trade node. And I might just do that, and I'll just stay off the water for the first part of this. But I'm eventually gonna need a navy to take on British. Sixth rate and a fifth rate. I'm just not gonna worry about trade right now. Just not gonna worry about trade right now. Already? That was quick. Can you go put this on my? I'm Lulu. You have to. I'm gonna get burned here. Thank you. Was it clean? Thank you. All right. Yep, it's good. Thank you. Okay, so I guess I can go ahead and send John Barry down and claim a trade note or two. Yeah, we're just going to do that. You go to South America. Oh, whoa.
I tingle with
anticipation. Yeah, we gotta put you in the university. We need to set up research. Give me that carcass shot. Need that carcass shot. Alright, next turn we will look into doing town buildings and stuff. Alright, intern. Think. Yeah, this should be fine. United Providence. Military. Give technology separation of power. Do we have a trade agreement? We do have a trade agreement. Okay. So they want a military alliance to deal with that. Who are your allies? Russia, enemies, Barbary States. Oh, well, looks good. Sure, we'll do that. Why not? Okay. House of Hanover, France, Russia. We're waiting for everybody to do their moves. Okay, the Mughal Empire. They want military. For a military alliance, they want to give military access. Their allies are Afghanistan, trade partners Afghanistan, March Confederacy. No, you're gonna have to give it more than that, buddy. Region. You got two regions, you're not gonna give me a region. It's technology. Ooh, they got cartridge shot. I mean, sure, I have nothing to do with you. And five, you want access for five turns to a. To land that you can't even get to in five turns? Sure, why not? Sounds like a great idea. Just give me carcass shot and we'll call it even seas. Yeah, no, I need carcass shot. Hell, I'll give you military access for 10 turns. Oh, no. They were going to grant me military aggro. Okay. Take that off the table. That's stupid. Let's, give me carcass shot. Yeah. Alright, whatever, dude. Whatever, dude. I don't even want your carcass shot. Hey, Lord Kalos, how are we doing? Okay, their demands, military alliance, and I pay you all this money. Kauai? You're just a weak little nation. I don't want to give you money. I don't even want to have a military alliance with you. Let's see. You give me technology? No, you can't give me technology. Yeah, I just don't want anything to do with you. Sorry, bye. Doing good. Is this the mod you were talking? Yeah, Darth mod. I found I was just not reading all the directions, so it was actually pretty simple. I just wasn't reading directions. To be fair, I was like trying to get it done and doing other stuff, but yeah, no. Great Britain and Austria are on the outs. That's horrible. I was really chipping them. All right, my turn. So what are you up to today, Lord Kalos? What's good about this mod? I don't know yet. Like, I've seen some new units. There is these, first Pennsylvania rifles. The Pennsylvania rifles were, you know, the snipers of the American Revolution. George Washington used them as a rear guard. to give any pursuing troops a lot of issues. They fought just like snipers do, a spotter and a marksman, and they give them 110 range. Well, I got long riflemen, over the mountain boys, or you know, 170 range, which okay, fine. That's a little crazy, but okay. The militia, they revamped militia. He's crazy. Gave you a continental troops. Your artillery, you have. They've limited the artillery that you can have, which I haven't figured out all the rules yet to that, but you can have howitzers from the beginning. That's kind of cool. Since howitzers were standard military thing if you could afford them, you know. So they added units. Your unit strengths, they're a little bit, they're more units. Like this one has 807, this one, line infantry have 225. Other than that, oh well, they made the which you've played this, right? I think you have. Yeah, they made the this little here sea on the coast of the Americas. It only takes one turn to get from here all the way to here. So they've changed some of those rules. All the way to one of these. They've gotten rid of trade ships, which I don't know how I feel about that yet. So I guess you just control a node and trade ships are, you know, not a factor in the game. Not a movable factor anyway. So yeah, other than that, I don't know. Diplomacy-wise, I just ended my first turn and they did, you know, people, AI was doing diplomacy moves with me. So I don't know if that means it's better or what. Okay, so I'm going to, but other than that, I don't know. So I'm going to be a colonizer real quick and tell the Cherokee to give me their land or I'm going to take it. And I'm going to declare war on them when they say no. Regions. Oh, they only have Kentucky. No, they have two territories. Yeah, blah blah blah. So I'm gonna declare war on them now. War, this is a good day to die, your warriors. Oh! Iroquois Confederacy has just joined them in war, so now I'm at war with Iroquois. So that's good. That was gonna have to happen anyway. Let's go for it. They outnumber me, but I got the better troops. We'll see what happens. Command surrender! They refused. Okay. I'm gonna fight this guy out. You're gonna see, this is my first battle on Darthmod. I'm gonna pause the music while we do this too, because it's gonna be too much going on. Hey, how's it going, batteries? Thanks for that lurk. You do that modding. All right. Oh yeah, and in the heads up display is weird, or the user interface, however you want to call it. It's weird. I'm not sure if I like that. I think I'd rather the old one back. But then again, I'm not a very big fan of change, so that's probably part of that. Okay. Yeah, there's definitely more troops on the field. I can see that, so that's good. We will have... I don't have any infantry, or I mean, I don't have any cannon, so I'm gonna have to do an attack. Light infantry in the back. So far, I've not seen anything horrible about the game. That helps. Okay. Okay, this is kind of weird. Why won't... That was weird. Okay, I don't know what's going on there. All right, so dragoons. Dragoons, light cavalry. So, if I dismount them, do they have? Yeah, they have rifles when I dismount them. So we will put them in the line. We got plenty of cavalry. These guys, I'm gonna move them through the trees. This is light cavalry. We got two units of light cavalry now. I don't think, can they dismount? No, okay, they're just straight up light cavalry. Well, this is provincial cavalry, cool. Okay, so we'll use these guys like infantry. What's their range, I wonder, when they're on the ground? I think I can find out. Yeah, there it is. I got 120 range. Okay, so that's it. They ought to be alright. Alright, we're gonna see what happens. Light infantry. We're going to go. Let's go to get in the trees if we can. Keep the cavalry in the back. Light infantry, let's go. These guys go in the front. Actually, come over here. See if we can't get any pop shots off of them. Of course, the Native Americans always have very good troops that can hide. Or a lot of troops that can hide, so. We will come out of the trees on them and use that to support our fire. Cavalry. I think they're going to have troops over here coming from the trees themselves, so. So we can get light infantry to get some good shots off, and then. Okay, there's something weird with telling the troops to march that's not working right. I mean, not march, positioning them. It might just be there's stuff in the way, but something's weird going on there. We're gonna put these guys here. Try to put them. Okay, so there is definitely something going on there. Look at that. Yeah, there's something going on there with this mod, probably. Or maybe there's just areas where you can't walk. Maybe they've changed some stuff there. No, look at that. I can't draw them out. It's not good. Okay, so far I'm not liking this mod. I can't tell my guys to go where I want them to go. Yeah, so far I'm not liking this. Okay. We're gonna form up, try to take this to cover, then we're gonna get these guys up a little bit more, start taking pop shots. We'll see if he can't get them to rush us, and then I will counter rush with our cavalry. Since they're basically just dudes, we should be all right. Actually, I'm going to move one cavalry unit because I'm going to try to get that bowman. Okay. Let's see if I can get him up there like this. Oh, there's something there that's not allowing them to. They can shoot through it, I bet. But we'll do that. Okay, let's move up onto this ridge. We're gonna try to get them to rush us, and then our, then we'll use our troops to give him a crossfire, a hellacious crossfire here. Can they go there at all? Or is that a blocked off area? I think that's a blocked off area. Alright, so we'll set him up here. Well, that one's just taking all kinds of fire. They're not taking the bait. Yeah. Well, these guys are supposed to be a little bit longer. I don't have the Pennsylvania with me yet. I got them coming with John Sullivan's force. They're still training. Alright. Yeah, they're not taking the bait, so... Look at that. I can't even draw them out. I hate that. What's going on? Maybe I can just draw them out separately. Dragons will save as a reserve. Okay. Halt that movement. They've started moving now. These guys go ahead and run to positions. Run to positions. And try to run through their bowmen. Okay, that's a little lack. That, what the hell? These guys, that's it? Y'all gonna run? Ooh, we gotta add. And they're chasing my... They're chasing and catching my cavalry for some reason. Okay. That's great. It's always great when cavalry acts like they can't run. Yeah, look, they're chasing and they're catching my cavalry. That's just crazy. Hey, Ozzy, how's it going? I'm having fun trying to figure out this new Darth mod. It's always great when cavalry just can't outrun regular units, you know? Alright, let's go ahead and charge these guys. Charge these guys? Okay, alt attack is not working anymore, that's good. Kind of thing you want to see. Well, they took a huge hit because they could not outrun these guys somehow, but still not too badly beat up. I'm not sure if I'm loving it right now. Seems like there's some crazy stuff going on as far as I don't know. Just that might just be not used to playing Empire Total War anymore. Been a while since I played this. Let's go see some hand-to-hand that fight. But it just seemed like some movement issues I was not prepared for. I think I was just in a bad area. And I was told the AI was better, and that what they just did was not better. They just pretty much sat there and got busted up by my long-range units. And they'd never used their bowmen at all. Oh, shit. Gotta get my general. Oh, there we go. I found some. And there's some more bowmen. That's okay. Run through them. It's all right. Oh, here's the bulk of their army. No wonder they weren't worried about anything. Okay, so this was just kind of a crazy situation. Come on, guys, get over here. This was just kind of a crazy situation that should have never been. Lost an infantry unit. That's good. This is... What are you doing? Oh, no, you are not following orders. I never ordered that at all. Alright, let's exchange some fire. Come on. AI does get it some improvement. Well, it didn't seem improved at this point. That was a little crazy, though. My own fault that this unit is retreating. Come on, guys. Let's go get into their rears. Should be able to make them run. Lost 50 men here. Yeah, this is kind of crazy. Why would they just... I don't know. If anything, it was my own fault, so no big deal. This should close them out, though. This should close him out. My first battle did not go stellar, shall we say? Right, it's true. It's still limit, you know, it's still the game. Alright, so we'll continue because we don't want these guys to run away. We're going to kill as many as we want, as we can. Here's my cavalry split up among them. I really don't know what the hell just happened, to tell you the truth. Anyway, we won't blame it all on the game. Some of it was my bad management. I thought I could just carry on the route, but it didn't work that way. So I probably lost a lot more men than I should have. Alright, where's my speed controls in this game? So what are you up to, Ozzy? Oh, I haven't given anybody shout-outs. So let me do that. Lord Kalos. Batteries. Separately. No, I guess everybody's going to be following everybody already, but, you know. Still. Other means. They're still chasing everybody down. Yeah, that's gonna suck. I shouldn't have lost that many men. I really screwed the pooch on this one, but I should have known they were gonna get reinforcements also. My own fault. Nobody to blame but myself. Oh, I think I just ran over one of my own guys. Now I haven't seen the artillery obviously yet, but also the speed. Why are these guys almost the same speed? I guess they're not. I thought the Indians were way too fast. Like I was gonna bait some of them away, you know, my cavalry away with them. Yeah, I lost 269. I would demote that guy. Oh well. Yeah, they were like really fast.
For war.
I thought I was gonna have them, you know, follow my infantry or my cavalry away just to get them to get them
prepare the troops for battle.
Out of how was I supposed to take over them in turn two when they're not even gonna have enough movements to go all the way to their capital. I don't know. Anyway, what happened? Do like splash screens too. Splash screens? What's splash screens? Splash screens. What's splash screens? Not sure. Alright, so now we burn this down. We can get our own town center in here. Burn it down. We don't have to burn that down. Let's burn that down. Oh, and religion. Isn't religion different too? Now it's more like it's society types instead. We'll plop a church in here anyway. Till I find out about that.
How may I serve?
So, let's finish converting Georgia so Georgia doesn't turn on me.
Obeying the Lord's word.
Screen images during loading. Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah, those are pretty cool. All right, let's see. Can we get these men up there in time for the next battle? I don't know. We'll send them up anyway. I guess that's where I was supposed to go. I was supposed to go around this way and attack their capital. I guess that was an option that I didn't think about. Oops. Alright, so there's that on that front. Where are you going?
Humble servant.
Yeah, you're going down to Sullivan's.
At the ready.
You're going to New York.
Yes, sir.
You're going to Wayne. All right.
Ready and awaiting orders.
You're going to...
Ready for orders.
Green to Green.
Ready.
At the ready.
Where are you going? You're going to join Green? There's
forward.
Green.
Yes.
These guys need to join up there, right?
And forward.
And then go ahead and send them up there.
Forward. March.
Wait, ready, they'll be there at the order. Beginning rather than the end.
Forward!
British are coming. The British are coming, right? They will be coming. I'll be going after them.
Make ready.
Go ahead and join them.
Troops!
We get a few more men going, and I'm going to go for Arcadia. I'm surprised I'm not at war with Britain right now, because I'm at war with Iroquois. That's gonna be fun. So let's do that real quick too. I'm gonna end up having Iroquois in my back door soon, so I'm gonna build another force.
Your orders?
They're building that. So we'll build a small force. They're building all of that. They're oddly enough not building anything. Let's build a couple provincials. No, we'll build a couple militia types. And we'll build provincial to go that way. Plus a foot artillery. No, we won't do that because it won't be ready. Alright, and hopefully I'll be able to get that built soon. Get in place. Okay, what else do I gotta do? So let's spend some money on infrastructure. Or not infrastructure, we'll spend some money on towns. Get you up to a governor's residence. You don't need that yet. Maryland. What do I need in Maryland so I can get the first Maryland? First Maryland. I wrote all that out before. First Maryland. I need a military governor's barracks. So we'll do that because I want to get the first Maryland as soon as possible. Anything else that will make people happy? How sad is Philadelphia? They're not sad at all. Okay. I do have some problem. I believe I do have some problem areas. Hold on. No, everybody's actually kind of happy. I always drop the taxes on the lower class just because that'll help them grow quicker. Ministers. I haven't even checked my ministers. Everybody pretty good? Everybody's on the pluses? Nobody's negatives where don't need to be negatives? Look, George Washington's the Secretary of State. Awesome. Poor guy. Let him retire. He's like in his 90s. Not really, but... pretty old. Yeah, everybody's doing pretty good. I don't need to kick anybody out of that. Okay, so we've got pretty good income. Nobody's real crabby right now. Actually, they're kind of crabby. They're not very happy. They could be happier. Give them an opera house. That'll make them happy. Shut up now. Shut up and behave. Oh, of course, they're not too happy. You just took over our land. You killed our people. Sorry. I had to for the game. All right. Rakes. I hate rakes, but we'll leave him there for now. Gotta check my rakes anyway, even though I hate them.
God's will be done. Ready for action.
All right, that's all I need. That's all I have. That's all I need. Next turn, we'll do ports. Let's go ahead and spend some more money on roads. Roads are going to be important so I can ship troops around. The FBI, open up. Thanks for that. Wouldn't say you scared me, but for a second there, I was like, what the hell? What did I do? What did I do this time? Let's build that road, too, over here. We're going to need that.
How may I serve?
All right, let's go on to the next turn. Yeah. Kind of crazy. So you know Darth Maldazi. Did they really get rid of trade ships? How does that work? I just got to protect the nodes I want then? I can't find trade ships. Oh. I need to do the $100, the ones that are in hundreds. I always do those. I build that up as quick as possible. Just keep those moving. Alright, looks good. 1783. I'll be born in 200 years. Let's go.
Setting up camp.
Do. Missed the question. Watching and doing homework. Oh, okay. That's fine. Homework or housework. Okay. I was going to say, there's homework even when you get up to that age, then I don't want to be there. Trade chips. Did they really get rid of trade chips? Do you just protect the trade nodes then that you want to use for trade? It's crazy. United Provinces is doing stuff. I guess I should have moved the map over so I can look to see what the Iroquois are doing. Can I have another cup of coffee, Lulu, while you're up and my beautiful niece? Lulu! She's gone. I'm going to have to get my own coffee. Get your own coffee, old man. Oh, really? What happened? Arr. Been a while, but I think you might be right on that. That's crazy. That's insane. I do like that they shortened the water passages. You can actually go from like the East Coast all the way to the transition points on the ocean in one turn. That kind of makes more sense than the whole two or three turns to get across that little piece of water. All right, Spain. What does Spain, terrifying and spectacular, want from me? They want a military alliance. They offered to give me military access. I can't even get to their territory in 5 turns, but I can walk around it for 5 turns. They'll give me 2,800. Now that's nothing to scoff at. Let's see what they're like. Their allies are people they have no contact with. Their enemies are as follows. Cherokee Nations. That's fine. Maratha. Oh, what am I talking about? Spain is right underneath me. I'm dumb. Pueblo Nations, Iroquois, Great Britain, Barbary States, and Plains Nations. I'm going to go with that because that might give me some natural wars. No, because then I have to take them out eventually. I can always go back on the alliance. I mean, what do I care? So usually I'm at war with Spain by pretty quickly. Yeah, I don't want their blood money or their alliance. Go away. Alright. Alright, thanks for the lurk. So I played 2 Tombstone Myers and Demo with my ticket to Tunnel Town. Guess it's a day for killer. Well, yeah, that's where the blood points are, right? You're following that around? So why did they... Oh, no, I get it. Sorry, I'm dumb sometimes. You got a tombstone mine. Oh, but they're so fun, though, aren't they? At least a couple matches. If they were like every match, it'd be like, oh, this is horrible. But at least a couple matches, it's exhilarating to get killed so much. He grabs you and you're dead, basically, right? yeah. Demo, I never really liked Demo. I hate the tunneling thing. Xeno, for some reason, I don't mind as much. But Demo, he... never really liked Demo. Alright, my path has been blocked. Where? Okay, cat. That's how you feel about things. Dark Star, war is declared. Who declared Polo? These places that have nothing to do with declared war on each other. These other places that have nothing to do with declared war on each other. I built a bunch of stuff. I recruited a bunch of people. And my path... Rootin' Toot Lulu! Rootin' Toot Lulu! Thanks for that, Lulu. Lulu's the bestest. More path blocked. I don't know why you're saying my path is blocked, but whatever. What's blocked? By each other, maybe? Okay. Iroquois moving in on me yet? The Iroquois are not moving in on me. I am at war with the Iroquois, right?
No. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. We do have casus belli. They're just not moving in on me. They're building forces. Yay. Okay, so we'll keep on chugging along on the hundreds of dollar improvements. Get the farms a farming. Oop, missed one. What was that? Oh, yeah, I know what that was. There's that. So I think those, Kalos, if you're still here, I think those marksmen have the Pennsylvania rifles. I think they've been built. Let's see real quick. Nope, not yet. Maybe they were already built and I just missed it. But they should have been built by now, so should be on their way somewhere. Let me see.
Make ready.
Pulaski's.
Ready and awaiting one. Make ready.
No.
Your humble servant, sir.
No.
Yes, sir. Sir. Your orders?
Your
humble servant.
Did I make him? Did I decide not to make him?
Ready for orders.
Pretty sure I did. Let's see. I can't see it yet. All right.
Make ready.
Let's go ahead and move them into over here.
Make ready.
Move them into over here.
Anything more?
I don't think these guys are gonna make it.
March. Any further orders?
You are. Okay. Now this is an army. Oh, I forgot to. Damn it! Because the games I've been playing are auto. I haven't. Oh, I didn't get any of the. Fixing the troops, whatever it's called. Replenishment. Can I go all the way? No. Okay. Who do I have to give it? What? Probably artillery. Nope. Artillery can make it. Who can't make it? The Pulaski's? Pulaski's can't make it. Well, that's a sad event. I really wanted the Pulaski's here. No, they won't be able to make it. I can never really tell.
Possible, sir.
Let's see. Pulaski's, make sure they're not the ones that can't make it. All right. Well, anyway, I'm not going to give him a chance to recruit their forces, so
March.
He can make it. Yep, he can make it.
You ask too much.
Your mom asks too much, really, if you think about it. Maybe they can't. Yeah, they can't make it. Yeah, they can't make it. So I'm not going to have artillery.
Prepare for war.
All right. They refuse to surrender. They seen how I ran that last battle. They're not scared of me. Oh, and Ozzy, thanks for the lurk. They're not scared of me. They seen how I ran that last battle. You know what? I can go ahead and just wait a turn because they won't be able to. They can attack me, but they won't be able to recruit while I have them on siege. So
siege works underway.
Yes. I can wait for that gun to
make
get up here.
Ready.
All right, let's go ahead and advance these movements. These movements should happen at the beginning of the turn. I don't know why they don't.
March.
They're effectively, unless you go through and move them by hand.
Sir.
Oh, that's right. I was taking one of these down here to making a army in Maryland.
At the ready.
Yeah. Unless you do this here, you're effectively saying that they won't be in. Wait a minute. Where are you supposed to go? Oh, it's because its movement was canceled. Well, I'll go ahead and send you to.
Immediately.
New York.
Anything more? Sir. Sir.
Alright, so this troop will be here. And I think I can go ahead and move in on the Iroquois if they declare war. Or, I mean, they already declared war.
next turn. And let's go ahead and recruit an... Well, unless I already did this, you should have already recruited a guy, so... Let's see. Deming cannons to move over here. I wish you could, like, build it and then give them an order so they can... So they know where they're going to be needed, because... Then you just plain forget. Alright, what else do I need to do? Trade agreements. That's right. I should have been doing that from the get-go. Can I do any trade agreements? Let's see. Well, definitely can't do trade agreements with people I've already had trade agreements with. Here's a trade partner. Oh, I can't have a trade because I don't have enough things. In a trade. Gold capacity. And I'm at war, or about to come war with anybody on this territory. So, all right. I need to go grab me another cup of coffee and then I'll be right back. Oh, sorry, cat. Sorry. Who told you to be black? Can't see you in the shadows. All right. Okay, so now we are on some real stuff. Recruit. Did I not make? Pretty sure I made those guys. I'm gonna make another. No, here they are. Yeah, they haven't been built yet. Okay, let's go ahead and work on that with whatever money I have left. Okay, so in Virginia. So what's first priority? New York. New York, I need a governor's barracks. I can build a governor's barracks and I can have the first New York there. So let's do that. Done. In Maryland, as I forget, as I forget that I didn't just forget which way was Maryland. That's already being built, or worked towards anyway. Eventually I'm going to need... Yeah, I got that already. I need a naval college somewhere, and I need a drill school somewhere to get my other special units. Okay. We are on our way. Convenience stores of Speedway. All right. We're moving along. I need to start building a navy, too. Because eventually I'm going to have to be facing off against Poldark here. The British. But I should probably go ahead and have this all... My army's well built first. Before I really start building a navy. So, there's that. Meanwhile, speaking about navies, when is that navy going to get to where it's going? Oh, he's already there. How did I miss that? Okay.
Heave away, boys. Heave away. Weigh anchor.
Ships orders, Captain. Orders, Captain.
I'm not at war with any naval powers, so... I'll just keep one on each trade route.
And
I will have access to the trade then. Let me see the trade map. Make sure that's the way this works. Trade. I'm not sure if that's the way it works anyway. Okay.
Make ready.
Is it a particular?
On our way, Captain.
No?
Orders received and understood.
I don't get what's going on.
Ship shape and Bristol fashion, Captain. Fleet ready.
I'm getting trade already out of the coast of Brazil. Ready for action. So is this going to give me more trade? Question. See the note says, come on, give me the note. This trade ships are used to create trade by occupying trade posts. Your trade are to find the trade theaters. I guess I let me just see. I guess I'll just Google it. Trade Darth Mod trade ship. Darth Mod trade ship. TW. Okay, let's see. So as far as I know, Darth Mod disables trade ships because the AI used to spam them. I spam them to use them as battleships instead of building war. I mean, but what's the point? Who cares? So what do you do instead? It's a question, sir. No trade ships. Put anything that floats in the trade port and there you go. Trade income. Okay. Okay. Okay, if that's the case, then I guess I just need to make fifth rates and put them on trade nodes. Since I can defeat a lot of armies or navies with fifth rates, just a fifth rate, then I don't know, it hasn't been working for me lately. But is it fifth or sixth? I always forget. I think it's a fifth rate. So we'll build another fifth rate and go take some more trades routes, I guess. That's the way that we're going to play it. That's the way we're going to play it.
Sir.
Where are you going? You've already spent all your moves. Okay. I'm waiting for that artillery to show up. So let's go ahead and turn. I'm technically at war with the Iroquois, but nothing has popped off yet, so we'll see. I guess that's good. Are we about to crash? I think we're about to crash. Nope, we're good. I guess that's good that I go to war with Cherokee like that, and then Iroquois jumps in on it, because that means I can go to war with the Iroquois without Great Britain getting angry. So, yay. That means I can usually have to deal with the Iroquois and Great Britain at the same time, which is very hard. As long as Spain doesn't pop off on me, I should be alright. Usually there are a lot of movements or my game's lagging. I guess there's more diplomatic movements because Darth Maul is supposed to help the AI do more diplomacy. All right, Maratha Cavalry or Confederacy. Yes, I'm going to give you Georgia for technology. Yes, that's what I'm going to do. Counter offer. I don't give you that, and you. Still give me. Okay. Didn't work. Okay. Spain. Love the flags were revamped to be more precise for the era. That's kind of cool. United Provinces in Russia are no longer friends. There's a strike. Oh shit, did I not get that magistrate bill? I did not get that magistrate bill. That's my own fault. My poor
sir.
Planning. All right, let's get you in there.
Forward.
And we'll go ahead and
raise the flag.
Do this battle. Looks like they're saying I'm going to lose. We'll see what happens. Actually, once again, what's the point? I can just keep on the siege and they'll attack me. I'd rather be attacked by them anyway. Okay, so we got that going on.
God's will be done.
Protestants, let's go ahead and move all that up.
Awaiting your instruction,
your
humble servant.
You're coming here.
Troops! Forward! At the ready.
You are going all the way down to Sullivan.
March!
You are
sir.
Going up to Wayne. No, you're going up to New York, right?
By the left! March, sir.
You're going to
more
New York.
Orders.
You're
ready.
Going
waiting
to
for
Sullivan.
Yes.
You were going to Sullivan. I don't have to need your marching orders, but that's where
sir.
You're supposed to go. You're going to
make ready.
Not Sullivan, Wayne, damn it. Okay. I have an army. Let's see what I got. I got this. I got some linemen. So this army's ready to move, actually, and we're already at war, so I'm going to go ahead and move in on the Iroquois. I think we're still waiting on something, but we got a pretty good army now, so. One more turn. Well, no, we'll just do our turns, whatever turns we can get towards it.
Any further orders?
Recruitment. Yep, that's it. Okay, so now, we probably have... Yep, we have some recruitment spaces. That's still not done. Let's get you for this small army. We're getting him another guy. And get him another demi cannon. Oh yeah, that demi cannon was supposed to go over here. Where'd he go? That 12-pounder foot, I mean. Let's come over here.
Forward for crown
and then,
country.
Can I move any further? No. Army, recruit. Yep. Okay. We have it going on. Let's go ahead. Oh, I was going to do ports. Fisheries. Get you more fishery. We're not going to build a navy yet, so we're not going to worry about that. But we can use some more commercial ports and more trade income. All right, there's that. Now let's go check out our $100 deals. Hundreds of dollars deals, what I meant. I think there's at least one. Yep, I think it's that one. Okay, and then this, I'll go ahead and build a chapter school. That can be done. Oh, there's another hundreds of dollars one. That should be all I can do. So we'll go one more turn with the Cherokee. Probably build. Well, after I take the Cherokee. Oh, the Cherokee has. No, that's France. Okay, never mind. So after I take this territory, I should be able to move this army back to Georgia, and that'll defend against Spain being bad. Alright, so we got all that going on. How are we doing here? How's Wayne's army looking? Oh, yeah, once you get this other guy, that'll be your artillery. Do we not have any more infantry coming towards you? Because we should. We ain't gonna have built this turn though. Okay, very good, very good. Everything's fine. Everything's going great. Here we go. I'm surprised Iroquois hasn't attacked me yet, if we're at war. Usually they'll send somebody in along this pass. It's Maryland. Kind of surprising. Go through the Blue Ridge Mountains.
Enemy sails!
Here we go.
All hands on deck!
Here we go. We're being attacked. Did we get any of the... Okay. Alright. It should be a pretty easy match for me since half their guys are pitchforkers. I don't know. Maybe they gave them some bonuses. All right, let's look for some defensible, good defensing, Yeah, let's get a good defensing position. We want to shoot as far as we can. Okay, move these forces back here. Put regular infantry together. Control. One. We'll get the Minutemen. Oh, the Minutemen are... Yeah, they're a lot smaller than this militia unit. And a militia unit can buy the skirmishers. Cool. Okay, so get a square going, or not square? Damn it, line. Let's get a fourth of a square going. There we go. Get these guys up ahead. Try to get some pop shots early and then move back. Unmount these guys. Nope, remount them. From here, unmount. They can do the same since they have incredible range as well. For some reason. Then Pulaski's we'll keep back here. Light infantry guys we'll keep over here. Nope, that's not what I'm going to do. Over here. Dragoons, we'll fight them with Pulaski's. That drawing again. I can't draw them. Get there at all. Oh, that's the dragoons that are over here. Yeah, what am I talking about? And the general's unit we'll bring back here. And that's where we'll start the battle at. No, we won't because that's not a good position. Let me go check out that position. Yeah, move forward. There we go. Anchored by this rough stuff. All right, let's end deployment. They have native warriors, tribesmen. Oh shit! I waited for them and then I forgot to frickin' place them. That's completely crazy. I forgot to frickin' place them, so they're not even gonna get kills. It'll be easy kills. Damn, that was dumb. In position, come on, we'll form up a new line around you. Dragoons, can you do... No, you can't. Okay, the control ease. All right.
Light horse artillery.
warm up over here. You can't bait them into your line unless you're shooting artillery at them. That is the rule. How's that position? Oh yeah, that'd be perfect once I get them in there. Once I get them in there, into positions. And unload. Oh, that was fun. No, we don't want to put you up there. We want to put you there. Okay, now these guys, we will do this here. We will drop these guys back. It's real fun, man. It's one of my favorites. I'm just now doing with the Darth mod. I would suggest the vanilla. The vanilla is plenty fun to me. But you are, I think you do a lot of mods, so you might be more into the mod. You'd be surprised how much alike from all the other, you know, melee primary Total Wars it really is. I thought it was going to be a big, like, change, and I wasn't going to like it, but I love Gunpowder Total War now. I don't want to place you there, yeah, I just want to see if I can. Guys, right there, and then I'll tell you to move back once again because that's a very good position. Alright, back. Where's their general? Real fun, I think. Oh. No, well, you have cavalry that they're not ranged. Early game, you have, like, pikemen and stuff when, you know, it's still pike and shot really still the major part of the, you know, war. Fire right there, right in front of you. Mount up. Come on, let's go. Run back. Light cavalry, let's go. Pull out the sides. Come on. Oh, where's the Pulaskis? Ah, damn. I didn't mean to let them get that close to you. Go, go, go. Okay. Come on, let's go. Attack him. Go, try him. Come on. Get him. Alright, now charge him. Get out of that battle. Come on. You don't need to stay there. You guys don't need to stay there either. Did you guys ever remount like I told you to? Come on. They're willing to chase you. Chase them. Let them chase you. Okay. Last kids, let's go. Run, run, run. Run, run, Rudolph. Come on. Drive through them. You don't need to stay there and fight them. Okay, you didn't need to do that.
They got my artillery. Okay, these guys go ahead and chase off that group of them. We will deal with this. I never told you to chase anybody. What the hell? Oh, fuck. I forgot to tell them to fire. Oh, damn. I took him off free fire because I thought I was going to line them up. Stay right there where you're at. I thought I was going to line them up and I didn't. Now this is happening. Horrible. But we've made it mostly. Is this Pulaski's guy still fighting it out instead of running through this unit? Or what the hell? You're Lancers. I never told you to fight it out. I told you to move. These guys are not listening to my orders. No. These guys are not listening to my orders. And look at this crazy little situation. Go after him. Oh, these guys are dedicated. They lost 2/3 of their troops. Oh, Pulaski, go back through them. Yeah, mostly won. It's still a little bit touch and go because that one unit lined up or decided to chase down some troops. Yeah, see? Just run through them, just like that. Yeah, that's all I wanted you to do. And then you guys can go chase after those guys. Yeah, you guys chase after those guys. You get to firing that guy. And you guys line up on this guy here. You guys just stop. Oh, they formed up again. Damn it. Should be running though. They don't have any. They don't want anything with this cavalry. I keep on chasing those guys so they don't form up again. You keep on chasing that guy so he doesn't form up again. These guys. Are these guys done with that battle yet? Nope, you're not. Surprised. Why are you guys not even lined up right? Run into position. Go, go, go. Yeah. These native troops are like really, really good on morale. Took some losses though. But hey, that's war, baddie. I was outnumbered 2-1. Alright, you guys keep on doing what you're doing. Actually, come on up here. We'll just squelch this unit real quick. That's pretty cool though. Watching them go through the whole whatever it's called of arms. Pretty cool. There's our captain. Oh, speaking about captains, I should get my general into a battle. Get some kills. We'll make that last unit run. It'll be great. Oh, we'll watch it right now. I think everything else is done except for these guys should not be firing. Yeah, we can end the battle. Now we'll continue so you can see some of the fighting. Now, these guys need to stop firing because I won. This is the general's unit out here just taking some skulls. Thrust was a little bit off there, buddy. Have to practice that.
I think that running through them works more on Napoleon and on Rome Total War than actual than Empire. I don't think it works as well. That's probably a thing from there. They do better. Cavalry is a lot better on Napoleon. But I still suggest going through this game first. Okay, man. Thanks for popping in. Morale for me up again and again. Yeah, no, seriously. It's like crazy that they're just a bunch of tribes people, but they're willing to die for their land, I guess. Sorry. Runs through one, then the other comes up behind. Yeah. Yeah, but what I was meant by that, I wanted them to run like away from all of them. And instead it just stays in front of with fighting hand to hand. Well, Lancers aren't very good hand to hand fighters. Why are you guys even still firing? Go home. Why are you firing through my own guys? Get out of here. I never even seen when they splattered my horse artillery. I'm surprised they stuck around. So sad. But yeah, try it out. It's not for everyone. Some people are like the older, older times, but it's a fun game for me. They make contact. I tell them to retreat. But like heavier cavalry. Like I'll have them run through. Like if I have to have them charge, any infantry head on. Yeah, I always try to get through their rears or, just keep them busy or something like that by having them chase them. I do that a lot, actually. But like if I ever attack them, I don't just tell them to attack because, they'll lose that charge bonus. Of course, spears, you don't want to charge them at all. But light infantry, which basically in this era and this time, that's what you got, except for like your line infantry that can form into squares. If you listen to any of like the you read books or watch movies, about this time, if you weren't in a square, the cavalry was going to come up and smack you on the head with their swords. It's basically, except for being squares, you're a light infantry, and here comes a guy on a horse. You have no armor. Yeah. Well, the map is amazing. The map is amazing. After I get out of battle, which I'm just waiting for the last enemies to route. Let me show you the map before you go off to bed. The map is amazing. I wish Napoleon, when they made Napoleon for some reason... Oh, okay. I don't watch too many people. I need to watch more. I'd probably learn more about these games. I mean, I would learn more, definitely. But, yeah. Yep, ad's over. Sorry about that. If I would have saw it coming, I would have snoozed it, so you wouldn't have to sit through them. Look at the dead on the battlefield. Decisive victory. Let me show you the map real quick. Then when they made Napoleon, they fixed so many issues. Like cavalry works better. I mean, just so many things. But they made the map smaller because it was all about Napoleon. He was just in Europe, mostly. Whoa. Yeah, I lost 350 men, but they lost, 2,000. So that's still pretty good. My general got a pip up. He was out there fighting stuff. I'm surprised they did. What am I talking about? They did get pips. Who all got pips? I think everybody, mostly, except for the horse artillery. Yeah, that was a good battle. I could have done a few things differently, but hey. You live and you learn. Yeah, as soon as the rest of them do their turn. Now let me show you the map. And the map on Darth Mod, like if you see this map, the little representation down here. It's different than vanilla. I actually rather in vanilla. It's vanilla is more of a satellite view, where this is like an old timey map view. I actually like the vanilla better. I could probably change that back if I really wanted to get into it. This whole heads up display just seems so different. Yeah, the mini map. That's the word I was trying to come up with. It was like the little thing, damn it, the little thing. Oh, come on, Ottoman Empire, don't crash my game. It is running a bit slower, though, I tell you that. The Empire Total War usually runs pretty quick on this computer since, what, 20-year-old game or something? I don't know. So it's definitely doesn't tax my computer too much. Task, whatever. Doesn't strain my computer. There you go. But the DARF mod has definitely slowed it down. But I guess that's to be expected. Come on. But yeah, the great thing about it is there's basically three maps. Yeah, there you go. That's basically three maps with like trade maps that are just ships and trade nodes. But there's three strategy maps basically. That's me every day, man. Come on. Oh, dang it. I didn't mean to. Oh, damn it. I just screwed it. Nope, here it comes. The North America map is not the same as the Europe map. I'm not sure what you mean by that, but chugga chugga. Yeah. I accidentally clicked off of the game when I tried to do something on my other screen. That's something else I've noticed about DARF mod. Usually, if I was playing Empire Total War, if I click on something on my other screen, it doesn't affect the screen, but doesn't this. It's probably, like, optimizing. Poland, Lithuania wants to be allies. Who's your enemies? You know what? Sure, why not? You might be able to drag me into a war I can go do. Yeah. Yeah, we're waiting for the enemy movements to go through. Alright, that's all done. So, yeah. So, here's the America map. And basically, it's most of North America. There's California that's missing. Decided that we didn't need it. And all of South America. Or, I mean, all of it. Most of South America is missing. We just need this area here. Bolivar's Empire. Yeah, this is the Europe map. Pretty amazing. Pretty extensive. You know, it's a lot. I think it's a bit more extensive than the other Europe maps. Maybe save, you know, like Rome 2, apparently. But I haven't done much movement in Rome. Yeah, Great Britain's a little bit more fleshed out, but it's pretty much just a little bitty island. You know, France again, Spain. You get North Africa, and this map adds a little bit more meat to North Africa, it looks like, because I think the vanilla map just cuts off here, and then it's just regular map, because you can't really do anything with it. But I mean, it's really useless, because they were trying to make an India there, I don't know. African India. The really cool thing about this map, it doesn't come up too much, because really, unless you were playing, like, maybe the Ottomans or something, but you can cross over into the third map, which is the India map. India, I think, got a raw deal on it. Rome 2? Okay. Okay. Yeah. And like I said, that's a little bit more... DARF mod added a bit more texture, you know, in the area. But yeah, the India kind of got a rough deal, because it's a lot bigger than this. You know, and you really not much to do, but I guess there's, you know, At this point, there's not too many cities. There's just a lot of open ground. Even the Mysore and Maratha, the Maratha Confederacy was, they didn't have too many cities. They were mobile. They were a mobile ruling class. Cities just kind of followed them around. They had big camps, basically. Well, that's kind of cool. But the cool thing to me, and I didn't even notice the first couple campaigns I made, is that you can go right to Europe and India. Like, there's a waterway that exists in Europe, and then you can sail down to India here. This whole land, all the stands and stuff, you know, are all out here, and you can do things. China's gone. China didn't exist in the Napoleon era. Odd thing. Not too many people know. But yeah, China didn't exist. And then you have the trade nodes. So here is the coast of Brazil, where I currently have some trade nooks. So in vanilla, you actually have to build trade ships and put them on these trade nodes. Ends in Persia, and I don't think it goes as far north. Okay, yeah, over in Europe, they do a little bit more up here as far as Scandinavia goes, I do believe. Yeah, it just has like a little land like up at the top, right? So this has all this. You could, I've sailed all the way up here, but by the time you get to Russia in this game, I guess, unless you play a different society. I only ever play America, because that's just how I am. But, yeah. Russia has so much expansive lands that I always get tired when I go to conquer the world. I always get tired and just call it done after I take Moscow. There's so much land over here. Yeah. Well, anyway, the trade nodes. Yeah, yeah. And it, Napoleon, they do a lot of, you lose a lot of people in the winter, you know, you lose part of, you know, that affects your army. So it's hard, you know, getting them in a town every turn so they don't get, whatever hell it's called. You don't lose men from that. So this is the Ivory Coast in Africa and its trade nodes. Madagascar. The southern, you know, the tip of South Africa, and then the West Indies. And you know, this area is here is how you get to the other maps by ships. Like, this will take you to the Pacific side of Mexico. There's nothing there. That's another weird thing about this map. This takes you to the Indies, that type of thing. In Europe, you have North America. You have three ways to get to North America. Oh no, two. Two ways to get to North America, and then Brazil here and whatnot. So that's kind of cool that you got this big map to deal with. I really wish they would go back to Napoleon and bring back this map. Let's call it Napoleon Era or Empire 2 or something. Yeah, you can drop an army off somewhere, but there's no towns that are no cities on this coast at all. You can drop armies off, I guess, and that will do things. But the jungle is just, you know, the jungle starts in Mexico and just goes on. So it's hard to move armies down through this area in Central America. World at War, Total War, World War One maybe, or the Great War before it. I would love like a Crimean War. Would be kind of cool. I think if they were to do that, I wouldn't even be so much about the map. They could just do like campaigns like they do for Napoleon War, and I would accept it. You know, and just restrict the technologies like a Spanish-American War, you know. Just make it a larger, you know, more detailed map, you know. But if they could just take some of the lessons that they learned by making all these new Total Wars and like add it to historic historical ones, maps, I'll be happy. Yeah. There's a lot of good stuff that they do. And like in Warhammer, they have a better things, you know, that gives probabilities of outcomes of battles that I like. That's true. But I haven't played it to see what exactly they done. But it was going to be a hard run anyway. You know, it's going to be a hard run anyway. Just, I almost feel like if they would have, you know, focused on smaller areas and not built a bigger map, smaller campaigns, I don't know. I haven't played it yet personally, so I really don't know. You don't really, yeah. I think eventually I will. It is one of my favorite historic times. You know, I'm more prehistory, but close enough. You know, and I haven't turned it yet, but yeah. I think they need to really just go back to the Napoleonic era, or really just, you know, this starts in like 1750 something. And mods can take you back to 1700s. But yeah, if you start this, I only do the Great Campaign or the American Campaign that starts at, you know, 1783. But if you know, you start at like 1751, you still have Pike, you know, it's more Pike and Shot, the end of Pike and Shot, pretty much. Pretty cool. I think if they were to go back and do more of the Pike and Shot era, that would be great. Yeah, it's a fun game. It's something different, you know. All the games have something different, and people will tell you Napoleon, you know, it's way better than Empire, but with this map, it's just so much you can do. I like taking over all North America, and by that time, I'm already getting involved in battles over here. And I usually end up with Russia, just run out of steam. I'm like, okay, we'll just call it over. But playing as some of the other, you know, you have Austria that starts off, you know, through here, and they really have a hard row, you know. They have Persia, which is pretty strong. Russia is like, you know, they can just throw men at the problem. France is kind of screwed in the beginning, I think. It's not as powerful as it should be. Yeah. It really draws you back. I just love this map. Napoleon Total War is fun. I'm glad I played it. It's just something about how restrictive it is, because they want you to stick to that, you know, Napoleon era and all the things that were important in that time. And then the scope gets real kind of smaller. I think if you played Napoleon first, you'd still want to, you know, and then played Empire, you'd still get into it. But if you play Empire first and you play Napoleon, you'll have fun, but it's like you feel the missing of that bigger map. Yeah. Navy ops worldwide, yeah. Yeah, that's the thing. Navy takes more of a meaning. I didn't even, in my Napoleon campaign, I didn't even mess with navies. There was no need to. You know? Other than jumping into Great Britain, there was really not much I needed to do with navies. I just went and looked. Pharaoh Total War isn't partaking of the Steam Winter Sale. Oh, that sucks. Ballsy move. Even Baldur's Gate is 10% off, and it won Game of the Year, right? Yeah, seriously. Yeah, they need to. Especially with the, I mean, I'm hearing a lot of bad things about Pharaoh. I'm not hearing anyone say that, you know, it's a great game. I'm hearing people say it's okay or it's horrible. Oh, did they just slash the price? Let me check that out. Also, have you guys ever tried CD keys? I get a lot of my games from CD keys because I'm poor. And you rock bottom prices. Some games aren't, though. Some games are not inexpensive at all, but rock bottom prices. Like, I'm gonna flesh out my Warhammer if I ever feel like doing that it's $40, so how much was it originally? Okay, there we go. Yeah. No. CD keys is not pirate, though. It's if that's what you're saying, that it's legit. It's apparently companies buy a lot of these games for some reason. I don't know what exactly it's about, and then they sell them real cheap. It's like, I don't know, maybe companies buying it for people. I really don't know how it goes, but it's legal anyway. It tells you right up front, you can only get the games that are legal in your country. Really? $100 or $100 what? Coffee bean? $100 Australian? Big apology to the community. What community? What are you doing? Oh, the Total War community? Yeah. They just came up with a patch. Well, a plethora of quality of life improvements and bug fixes. All right, there, batteries. I know how it goes. I'd say I'm going to bed about 5 times before I actually get there. Thanks for popping in and chatting a bit. Free content. Oh, nice. But yeah, eventually I'll get to Pharaoh. I'll have to get there. It's the era. I love the era. Eventually I'll get to all the Total War, and I'll just keep on coming back to Empire. All right, have a good night. I'm going to wait till Pharaoh Mummy? Mummy Edition? Yeah. But let's see what else I want to do on Total War tonight. Or Total War. Yeah, you guys know what I mean. Okay, so George Washington has a mistress now. That's great. Saxony's got destroyed. He'll be back. Mughal Empire and Great Britain are at war. Oh, look, my Pennsylvania rifle finally got built. That's good. Even half price, a little price, knowing how much they bring them down eventually. Right. Yeah, I always wait till my stuff's on the bargain bin. I started my foray into Total War on the bargain bin when I was at a store that sells... they buy out stores when they're closing down and they sell their products there. It's called Big Lots over here. That's where I found Shogun Total War. I think it was like $9. That's probably a good 10 years after it came out. So my headphones didn't blare, button didn't work, so I clicked it 4 or 5 times and my computer froze. Black screen turned off. Well, that's not good. Yeah. Well, that's the way I am. I used to play the same game for years. I mean, years. I wore out CDs back in the day. I mean, I wore them out. The only reason I got this computer is because my Xbox 360 finally died. And now I get a new game at least every couple months or so, and like, when am I ever going to get to any of them? The Continental Marines finally got built, and my Pennsylvania Rifles, so I'll get to see how they do. Cherokee Nation got destroyed. Who did that? Oh, that was me. Alright. So, now I have the Cherokee Nation territory, so let's see what I have to do to that. I gotta burn down their government center. 360s are cheap. Mine died last year, so I picked up one for $60. Super cheap. Yeah. My wife had just bought a Switch, and we ended up with two Switches, and she... Like the one we had, the light that you can't put on TV, and she rattered that one. So I kind of took over the Switch, and I got into DVD and did my daylight on the Switch. So I didn't bother buying another system. And then I got offered a great deal on this computer. So I bought it, and I started picking up my old Total War games. So. That's kind of where I got here. Yeah, I'll probably, you know, one of these days I'll get the ick to play my zombie, Nazi zombies. And I'll probably be back to pick one up eventually. Actually, I had one offered to me, Xbox One, actually. I haven't got there yet, though. I'm like, I've got so much to play on computer yet, and I can't stream off of it, and it makes me feel better if I'm playing video games. If I'm streaming, it makes me feel like I'm doing something instead of just wasting my time. So if I wanted to stream off it, I'd have to buy more equipment. I don't want to do that. I have to buy more games. Yeah, that's just too much right now. I'm doing all my low-cost improvements right now. That's what I usually do. That way I don't have to stop and think which ones I actually need. Play Dynasty. Yes, Dynasty Warriors. Yes, actually, that's the two games I would play. I'd play Nazi Zombies on Call of Duty Black Ops. And I actually bought three before it died on me. And Dynasty Warriors. I think I had Dynasty Warriors 8 or something. Or 5. Somewhere around there. Anyway, somewhere in between. Yeah, I love Dynasty Warriors. I just bought that one too. The new Dynasty Warriors. The newest Dynasty Warriors. I can't even remember what it was for Xbox 360 when it crashed on me. 8, yeah. That was a little weird, though. They had a lot of that role-playing setting that I wasn't really into learning how to play, so I didn't even play it that much. But I was happy to have it.
Yes, sir.
All right. You guys are going down. I was going to send you to Wayne, but I think I'm going to redirect you to Green because... Green's actually going to get into some fighting, and I want to see how you do. Ooh, go ahead and start moving that way.
Ready for battle, sir.
Where you going? You can go ahead and go to Maryland. Oh, it doesn't look like Iroquois is going to come in and try to take Maryland, sir, from me, so whatever. You go down there. We'll garrison down there for a bit. We'll get out of there. Since we have our buildings. Yes. All right. Here we go. We're ready to do this. I wish I can get Pennsylvania. Well, they'll come in as reinforcements. What other troops am I sending? You're going up that way. All right, we're ready to go.
Yes. Form line for battle.
And again, we're outnumbered, but I have the better troops. We'll be alright. Surrender! Refuse. Okay. Am I... Yeah. I would rather have had more infantry. I think I should have recruited a bit more regular infantry, but we can do this. Pretty much the same army I've fought and defeated with the... it's not as many troops, so... We'll do it. I still can't part with my 360. Some good great old games there. Yeah. Yeah. Like, I've never been a guy to go out and get the newest games. I never, for one, spend the money. And for two, like I said, I get stuck in games and play them for years. All right, let's get everybody organized. Militias and my infantry in one. I only have one cavalry unit. Get these guys three. No, man, I've been beeping too much. Alright, so let's see. Kind of terrain do I got? Horrible terrain, but well, I'll be able to call the shots because my howitzers will be drawing them towards me. We'll move the army. Move the army right here. Pull them back a little bit. Get them out of the trees. Get out of the trees. Pretty good. All right, man. Back in the day, I didn't read your last message. Back in the day when I was young, my buddy and I were super stoners. He played Lu Bu, I played Guan Yu, and we played the hardest maps on the hardest difficulties for Dynasty Warriors 5. Good times. Also, Pang Tong. I don't know what that means. They nerfed him, and his Musou power was devastating. Now it's meh. Yeah. Lu Bu is one of those characters. He was always strong if you didn't face him. If you faced him, you know. If you were him, he wasn't as strong, of course. But Lu Bu was always pretty strong. See, this is the wrong kind of lineup. You want your best infantry out in the lines. Okay, but they're not coming to me anyway. All right, we will put them there. Our cavalry will hide them up here. I think the light infantry we're going to put over here, they need a nice long. And this is the problem was, how do I get to my advanced formations? How do I get to my advanced formations in this game? How the hell do I get to my advanced formations? Oh shit, I didn't mean to move those guys. How the hell do I get into my advanced formation? You gotta put them in simple lines so they stop doing them like that. Oh, damn it. There it is. Alright, my rifles. We'll line them up on this side. Because they can do more good on clear land. And my... Try to hook, if they come in on this side, I'll move my horse artillery right here, set them up, set my lights on either side of them to protect them, and I'll get them up where they can fire into the flanks. If they don't, then I'll move this whole line here they come after my howitzers, which more likely they're going to do. Let's move them up a little bit. Okay, hold on. Pang Tong was a general for Liu Bu. Oh, that's funny because that's my favorite general. That's who I always played as. His triangle move was to use his staff as a skateboard and fly around, and his muscle was to jump in the air. Then everything in a five-person radius around him exploded repeatedly for about 30 seconds. I don't think I remember anything about that. Devastating muscle. Super glass cannon. Fly in on your staff, muscle. Fly away, and your flying would hit enough guys to recharge the muscle. Wow. I don't remember. I know what you're talking about, though, so. As far as how to spell muso, so worked. All right, we're gonna end deployment and start this out. Of course, they got some armed tribesmen out there. That's fine. They can go ahead and try to come in if they want. Oh yeah, the artillery does look a lot different. Okay, so it doesn't look like they're lining up anybody against me, so we're going to take the light infantry, move them up here. And there's the trumpets. We're going to set up horse artillery here. That looks like a good... I'm just going to try to draw them in with my artillery. If it doesn't work, because Darth Maul made them smarter, we'll reposition everything and get going. Bring them up here. Them up. Pretty sure I'm... Oh, I reread that. I believe my range now, it's range, yeah, the range is pretty incredible. Look at us, we lit some fires over here. They've already lost like 30 men to my artillery. Crazy. What did I forget over here? Oh, here's my Pulaskis, or not Pulaski, hell. My Marines and my Riflemen. That's kind of cool. Marines can do square. That's good. So here they come. I'm going to send them. No, we can't send them on an expedition. They will attack. Well, maybe that's a good idea. Get them into more closer into artillery range. Let's line them up over here for now. I figure out what I'm gonna do. What are you firing? You can't even see anything. Alright, let's do this. We're gonna get you guys over here so you can take some better shots. And cause some trouble. If I can get them to come after my light, my rifles and my horse artillery, then I can swing my infantry on them. Was that like a rifle misfire? Yeah, it's real cool the way it shows them all loading. You're still in here, you finally went to sleep. Roll it back into place. You do the whole thing. And looks like they do it a lot more detailed in Darth Mod. You're missing a hole, bud. You're missing a hole. They must have the same animation for field artillery as they do.
What's your
Oh, here they come. Where's my Howies? Bust them up. We might go ahead and we might have a ball game here, folks. Go up a little bit. And now. Might have a ball game. They might be coming. Yep, they are coming after this flank. Good idea, but it's not going to work for you. Look at that. They should have way farther, Well, they move so fast. I thought they were cavalry. That's gonna work out for you guys. Sorry, guys. Too many guns for you. They're going for them tree lines, but trees ain't gonna stop that many bullets. Why don't we get these guys back a little before they get blasted in the head by their own cannon? They're gonna need some help over here. We'll get the cavalry over here. Okay, you're matching up against the Pennsylvania Rifles. They're gonna beat you. Pullback. Okay, get you on canister. And you guys pull back a little bit more. Oh, no. Nope, stop. Nope, it's okay. Okay, we got this. Concentrate on that. You go ahead and concentrate out here on that. Yep. Alright, get Pennsylvania wrapped around. Nope, they're coming in. Now, they got some pretty good morale, these guys. Cannon shots. Let's drop some HP on these guys. Okay. Now they're ready to come back. Go ahead and change back to canister. We'll keep them running. Enemy general's dead. Let's swing around now. Are they running? Are they routing? They're broken. Okay. See, they're broken. Alright. Let's get our artillery to help out here. So sorry for these guys, but it's war. They still got some musketmen back there. Let's go ahead and move forward with some infantry. Keep them from running, or keep them from stop running. Look at that, these guys still. They'll do something over here. Retreat already, you people. You're broken. You're beat. My artillery has got you beat. And then some musketmen. Go ahead and swing these guys back. Get some better shots. Run now. It's the age of gun, not the age of the tomahawk. Got some HP on them. Okay.
Where's my cavalry? Go ahead and charge up this flank. And these guys can go ahead and stop. Go after guys. We'll take up this position here. Oh, here they come. Hamptons, there's some special units up there. They should be ready to go. If they're routing, they're not broken yet, but. Dropping in on them. You guys go ahead and chase them out. Oh, they're gone. And you can't see them. They're not gone. General's unit, go ahead and come out and get some kills from over here. It's a random one. So the Pennsylvania Rifles had very good aim and very good morale. They only lost 7 men, so they're not too weak. Hooks. Nobody's firing at us, though. Now, Pennsylvania. They're coming in on us. Yep, that's a lot to deal with right there. They're coming in.
Oh shit! Stop! Pick him up.
That's the end of that. Did General get any in on India? No, he's not. Over here. Get in on some of this. Let's see, what am I doing? Continue in battle. I don't want any of these troops to retreat. I want my general to get in on the action. These guys are still running. Still fighting a running battle here. Alright, you guys go ahead and stop firing at Will. Yeah, you too. Stop firing in the back of your own men, please. I'm chasing those guys. He's gonna kill everybody. Don't kill everybody. I want my general to get over here. Okay. Come on, Nathaniel Green. Get up here. Get some kills. What you got? Here they come. Get up there. Get some kills. Come on, Nathaniel Green. That must be you right there. Go, go, go. Go, come on. I think Napoleon Total War, Dwarf Mod, the Dwarf Mod for Napoleon lets your general, like, form battle formations. I think I read that somewhere. Heels. Great bladed cavalry. Swords. Trying to think, would they have been straight bladed at that point? I think so. I think it would have been. Like, it looked like they were using spadoons. You guys, you're missing them. They're over there. Look at them charge. Look at them charge. Look at the charge. Oh, yes. Remember, the point fleet beats the edge. The point beats the edge. They're going to get a huge bonus, too. Kills. That's going to be interesting because since the units are stronger, or I mean, stronger, there's more of them. When you have a routed unit, they're going to give you more kills. I wonder if they adjusted for that in the pipping process. Decisive victory, of course. Oops, sorry about that, guys. Didn't mean to fart on stream. It happens. Part of life. Yeah. That was terrible. I can't even feel good about that. Lost 156 men. Probably most of them do. Yeah, they only killed 113, so some of them was just friendly fire incidents. My general picked up. Militia did. Provincials. Did the Pennsylvania? Yep, the Pennsylvania pipped up. So, this is still... I can't... Can't move the list. Oh, that was fun.
Battalions ready!
Ready and awaiting orders.
Immediately!
That was good stuff. Good stuff. Good stuff. Oh, I forgot to see how many men he actually killed, though. All right. So other stuff has happened. I've already clicked through all this. All right. Iroquois has been irasacked. Yeah, the Iroquois aren't going to last too long if Britain's not going to war with them for them. Now there's a proper army with soldiers with guns, not just regulars, not just villagers. Probably going to attack him. Army. Oh, there's a... Oh, the Delaware could have been in that battle. Damn it. Darn. I got the Delaware in that battle. All right, Delaware... Let's go ahead and join the army. I guess I should have checked on that before I fought it. That sucks. Oh well. And you're going to this little army that's apparently not going to be used. Alright, so I made a boat. Now I shall float that boat to... Ivory Coast. Or I mean Brazil. Okay. Then I make another boot. That's the only boot I made. Alrighty, so now let's see how this is going. You guys are I should exempt you from taxes for a while. Be happier. Just started the process. Oops, I meant to build you. Wait, is that a native iron mine? Huh. Okay. Weaver's Lodge. Let's see what's going on here. Iron Workshop. Does that make people angry? That one doesn't make people angry. That one makes people angry. Oh, I don't like Iron Workshops. Iron Workshops are the best. Alrighty, so we did all that we did. So we gotta start garrisoning, so we will wait until that magistrate's built. Actually, we can just do this. Build a couple militia, and as soon as they get built, we'll send them over there to Chickasha. And we will keep that garrison and move that army down here to Georgia. Meanwhile, building Wayne's army to start the war with Great Britain. Kind of don't want to do it now. They haven't started the war with me. Alright, so... Well, we've been up for about 3 hours. I think we can call it done at this point. We had a good start on it. Man, I love me some Empire Total War. Darth Mod looks good. Things look different. I like the bigger army size and whatnot. So, it's a good. So, we're going to go ahead and save over our old stream game. Because we didn't get very far in anyway before I decided to change. And we will overwrite. So, let's see who's on. Who is on? Anybody is on from our... Yeah, AK Katz is playing Vermintide. Let's go see what AK Katz is doing. How's that? Sound like playing, guys? Let's go do that. He's playing Vermintide. Great game. I need to make some time for it myself. AK Katz. All right. Thanks, guys. Thanks for everybody who jumped in. Thanks for the lurks. Thanks for the chatters, for everybody. You all been a lot of fun. Who will go with me to go see AK Katz? Come on. A lot of fun. Playing Vermintide. It's a good game. Yeah? Nobody? Anybody else? Just two? Well, two's a party. Thanks, guys. Thanks, everybody. You guys were awesome for being here. And I will catch you on the flip side. Nighty night.
There's a weakling now, Buckhelm! This thing's probably gonna die before I get there. It did die before I get there.